The results of the first One News Verian poll of the year have just been revealed. And while it's good news for National, who have seen a popularity boost, alarm bells are now ringing for Labor leader Chris Hipkins. Meanwhile, a minor party's registered one of its best ever results in our polls. Deputy Political Editor Mikey Sherman has the exclusive numbers.
After a big election result and a big start to the year, here are the numbers from our first One News Verian poll for 2024. Take a look. National still the crowd favourite, up 1 point, sitting at 38%. Christopher Luxon's cool head during the treaty debate paying off. Labor's steady on 28, a false sense of security. The party hasn't capitalised on the coalition's chaotic start. The Greens have taken some big knocks and the biggest drop in our poll, down 2 on 12%. The treaty debate doing no favours for ACT. It continues to slide down 1 point to 8%. This is the worst result for ACT in almost 2 years. It's steady as she goes for New Zealand First at 6%. Winston Peters is here to stay, but watch out. Here comes Te Pāti Māori. The Greens' loss is their gain, up 2 points on 4%, their best result since 2017. And the Opportunities Party, not in Parliament, but still registering with voters. So let's swing over this way now and see how that translates to seats in the House. Labour would have 35, add in the Greens 15 and Te Pāti Māori 6. That's 56 seats, not enough to form a government. Adding National's 48 seats to ACT's 10, that's 58. They'd still need New Zealand First 7, Winston Peters still holding the balance of power, a comfortable 65 majority on the right to rule Parliament. Now here's the real clincher. Preferred Prime Minister, check this out. Christopher Luxon is steady at 25%, but ding, 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 ring the alarm bells, Chris Hipkins has nosedived, his popularity plummeting a whopping 10 points on 15%. He's standing on shaky ground. Winston Peters, meanwhile, has risen in popularity, now on 6%. David Seymour steady on 4%, but he has company. It's Chloe Swarbrick jumping up 2 points. She's running for the leadership and voters are running to back her. Yet another problem for Labor as the political year gets underway.
Well, welcome back to school. Did you have good summers?
Yeah.
Back from summer and into a new term of government, our politicians are schooling up on their new roles.
It is tough, isn't it? Yeah, it is tough.
With everyone trying to find their new rhythm, some are syncing up more than others.
We're taking the time to take stock and to rebuild after an election loss.
You know, I'm very proud of the start the coalition government's made. We've got a very good plan for the first 100 days.
In reality, the first 100 days of the coalition have been chaotic. New Zealand First scrapping smoke-free laws, ACT introducing the Treaty Principles Bill. And a coalition breakdown over policing numbers causing big headaches.
Well, I mean, like anything, and any, you know, there's compromise within a caucus, within an existing party, let alone between parties, and so you know, that's part of the process.
Christopher Luxon is in danger of becoming the compromise king, the first red flag perhaps agreeing to have two deputy prime ministers.
No, we're not sharing it either.
He's adamant the tail isn't wagging the dog.
Not at all. No, we're very constructive in the sense of we are united on the big things that are about driving our government forward.
I think people are a bit concerned about the shaky start that they've had.
Speaking of shaky starts,
polls fluctuate, I think, you know.
Chris Hipkins still desperately in denial, even as his personal popularity as preferred Prime Minister crashes through the floor.
Naturally, I'd love it to be higher, but I'm also, you know, accept that I'm not the Prime Minister.
Labor and its leader have been dormant, licking their wounds and lapping up a long summer.
People were quite happy to see politicians take a bit of a backseat for the summer break.
But when the break should have been over, the party couldn't even be bothered holding its January caucus retreat, failing to pounce on prime political turmoil from the Greens and the government.
Well, we're going to be setting out in due course, you know, a refreshed lineup for the Labor Party, a refreshed platform for the Labor Party, some new ideas and some new thinking.
Labor and National facing their own respective battles in wrestling back the narrative.
How has Chris Hipkins ended up with such a poor result in this poll, Mikey?
This is a major problem for Chris Hipkins. He's been caught sleeping at the wheel, snoozing under the summer sun. And the problem is, if he doesn't turn that around, people will forget who he is, and that will make his job a lot harder. Now, critically, it also opens up a real opportunity for the Greens to become the default party on the left. Chloe Swarbrick has made abundantly clear that she is keen on doing that. Labor is set to have its delayed caucus retreat next month, so that will be the prime opportunity for Labor to rev itself up and get its head back in the game.
On the other side of the ledger, of course, you've got the National Party. That first 100 days are almost up. Where to now?
Certainly yesterday's State of the Nation speech by Christopher Luxon was him giving the country a bit of a boot up the backside. And let's be honest, we all need that from time to time. The real risk there is that it doesn't become baked in and he doesn't become a patronising Prime Minister. No one wants that negativity. And in the first 100 days of this government, it has been quite negative in terms of scrapping this and repealing that. Now, the first 100 days expires in 3 weeks' time. Then it's over to the new government to bring in its new policies and for Luxon to provide a vision going forward. Now, in terms of that, he'll need all of his coalition partners. So for more on the minor parties, his senior political reporter, Benedict Collins.
A Member of Parliament caught in the act. For the high-profile Green politician, it was game over. Next, their co-leader was on his bike. But the Greens argue this poll proves there's been no descent into chaos.
Even with the rocky start that we have had, I'm pleased to see we're still well above our election night success, which was the biggest success we've ever seen.
Losing an MP a month is not really what people like to see, but let's see where they go next.
ACT's seen its own fair share of controversy recently, but David Seymour doesn't believe backlash to the treaty bill contributed to ACT's dip.
I think to read so much into such a small difference with 3 months between polls, that would be a bit silly.
The Greens, though, like what they see.
I'm pleased to see that ACT took a hit because I know on the ground we've got generations of Māori and non-Māori now who understand what it means to want a te tiriti.
And the Greens' likely co-leader-to-be, Chloe Swarbrick, is now equal with David Seymour in the preferred Prime Minister stakes.
That's a massive bonus for the Greens. She brings strength to our kaupapa.
I've always believed politics should be about the exchange of ideas, and frankly, Chloe owes me a few.
And even with their leader representing us abroad, New Zealand First stayed on steady ground. Te Pāti Māori were also all smiles today.
Hey, I don't get booed out of Big Gay Out. I'm doing great.
It's their strongest result in our poll in 7 years.
To see us at 4% on, you know, what are clearly, you know, polls that are driven by non-Māori is a really great reflection of what we've seen out on the grounds.
A party promising to keep up the fight. Benedict Collins, One News.
Bit of a surge for Te Pāti Māori in our poll. Is the treaty debate at the centre of that?
Absolutely, I think it is. I think this is a clear message from voters that they don't want a country divided. Race relations have dominated the headlines ever since the government formed, and the two parties at the forefront of that have been both Te Pāti Māori and the ACT Party. It's no surprise then perhaps that you could read into that as being a rise for Te Pāti Māori, a drop for ACT. What else does that tell you? In terms of the left, though, it is going to be an interesting watch because you do have Te Pāti Māori riding high, but you also have huge hope in Chloe Swarbrick, and of course these numbers would have been the wake-up call that Labor needed. Now, in terms of both the right and the left, they both need to go after that centre voter. Neither side took votes off each other in this, so over the next 12 months, we'll watch it all play out.
Yeah, watch the space. Kia ora, Mikey. Thank you very much.